Hi everybody, this is Pastor Susan and welcome to day 5 of our week-long series on prayers of gratitude. How do we express our gratitude to God even when things are going, well, let's just say they're tough? How do you say thanks in the midst of that? Jesus, one of the things that he did before he was arrested and tried and crucified, he knew what was coming. And he had a conversation with his disciples. We call it the final discourses, or Jesus's kind of his last words to his disciples, knowing that this was going to happen. And Jesus was telling them the hard truth, not only what was going to happen to him, but what was going to happen to them, that they were going to have some tough times that they would go through as well after he left them. And so Jesus wants them to be aware, but he also wants them to know that in the midst of the tough times, there is a promise. So I'm going to read now from John chapter 16, and this is beginning with verse 4 through 7. Jesus said, after he told them what was going to be happening with them, that they were going to come through some tough times, he said, I said these things to you, so when their hour, that is the difficult time, that difficult time comes, you may remember that I told you about it. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you, but now I'm going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asked me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you a truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. Here, Jesus is talking about the Holy Spirit, that ongoing presence of God that has remained with God's people for now over 2,000 years. The gift of the Holy Spirit, that is that comfort, that one who advocates for us, that is with us and gives us power and strength to face difficult days. My prayer for us today is that we will remember that we have not been left as orphans, that God has made God's self made known through Jesus the Christ and through the Holy Spirit, so that we might not only know up here the will and way of God, but that we might know in here that God is active and present in our lives. For this, we can be thankful. With the difficult circumstances we may find ourselves in, we may be thankful that God is faithful. God has provided the way for you and me to experience life, life in the full. The whole life, the abundant life that Jesus said he came to give. Does it mean that we're never going to have a struggle? No, it doesn't. Does it mean we can be grateful in the midst of struggle? Yes, it does. And so today, let us give thanks. Let us give a prayer of gratitude for the faithfulness of God who sends us the Holy Spirit to give us a sense of knowledge that God is always with us, and that God provides a way, even when there seems to be no way. God's working in ways we cannot see. God's making a way for you and me. I love that song, that God will make a way. And the Holy Spirit is there to be with us. Today, let us receive the Spirit again. Let us acknowledge His presence. Let us give God thanks for the ways in which God is like a father and mother to us in times of struggle, and let us commit ourselves to allow God to fill us so that we can be that witness to a world who needs to know that even in the midst of trial and struggle, that we are filled with the love, the peace, and the power of God. Let's pray. Loving and gracious God, we do give you our thanks today and our gratitude for who you are, the God of all creation, the God who comes to us in a personal way and shows us that the life that we live can be filled with meaning and purpose and power through your Spirit. Thank you, God, for reminding us that no matter what we face, you promise to be with us. May we open ourselves to recognize where you are showing up, and give us, Lord, the ability to acknowledge you, to embrace you, and to follow you wherever you lead. We give you our thanks and our praise for your ongoing presence with us and for the grace that you always offer. We love you, God. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.